menace that holds many neighborhoods hostage.
And those neighborhoods are no longer limited to Southern California. Chris Blatchford joins us now with his series on the 18th Street Gang. Chris.
Well, they do call themselves 18th Street. Critics say don't glorify them with any attention. But for years, no one has publicly spotlighted this group, and now they have grown to be the largest gang in Los Angeles and constantly increasing their ranks.
Wait. He is only 13 years old, a baby-faced youngster about to take a step that could begin his indoctrination into a life of crime. It is a beating ritual called jumping in that lasts 18 seconds. 15, 16, 17, 18. An initiation ceremony into the South Side faction of the 18th Street Gang, the city's largest.
It's an army. It's an army. It's not all our army.
We got more firepower than the sheriffs.
We call each other soldiers. That's what we are. Okay, you sent one of my soldiers into a war. We're already dying for our neighborhood. That's right.
18th Street.
For 18th Street. Yeah, that's right. It's a pride thing. We got a lot of pride.
Southside 18th Street.
A crime-based army. 18th Street now has an estimated 12 to 20,000 members citywide, and it's growing all the time.
You mess with us, you pay the price.
Hundreds of tattooed neighborhood cliques like this one have formed under the 18th Street umbrella.
You know, it's the biggest and the baddest. Everywhere you go, you see 18th Street.
It all began in the Rampart area 30 years ago. The original gang there is now called West Side 18th Street and has spawned branches that became East Side, North Side, and South Side 18th Street. In Hollywood, it is hands up. Cops drawing guns, constantly trying to keep 18th Street violence under control. In Cudahy, you see them bury their dead during gang-attired funerals. A mother's tears not enough to drown the terror. Growing graffiti lists of the 18th Street dead scar walls citywide. Police officers like Hector Camacho call it unfortunate for everyone.
Their whole concept in existence is on violence and corruption and drugs and everything else. And it's sad. To me, it's really sad because you see a lot of good kids that get sucked up into it.
Hey, welcome to the South Side. Welcome to the South Side Search Gang. It's there.
And 18th Street is sucking in new members at an alarm. Violence-prone taggers called KWS.
We're hundreds deep. You know, it just, we were strong. We just made ourselves stronger, that's all. We just made ourselves stronger by checking out with the robbery.
And police say this 10-year-old immigrant who sold drugs for 18th Street in Hollywood is a typical recruit. 18th Street was the first Hispanic gang to let in all illegal immigrants, blacks and Asians. This former gangster says those recruiting methods since the beginning spurred 18th's growth.
They got the rejects, bringing in border brothers and different races. They had to work twice as hard to gain respect. Gradually, they just grow.
18th Street, according to law enforcement sources, now has factions in San Diego, San Francisco, Denver, Dallas, Houston, Tucson, Phoenix, Seattle, and Portland.
No more hanging out here, guys.
Portland police say 18th Streeters are recruiting here like mad. There is also evidence of 18th Streeters infiltrating El Salvador and Mexico. And this former gang member says L.A. area factions are close, organized, and solidified by a peace pact.
That move right there gave them a lot of respect. They no longer killed each other. The unity came in. The unity brought strength.
A strength heightened, say insiders, by illegal immigrant recruits with drug connections south of the border.
You know, it's already a high narcotics area. And basically all the dope's being sold by you guys.
They supply 18th Streeters with dope to sell, put money in their pockets, and give them ties and influence with the feared Mexican mafia prison gang.
You know, it's no longer just a neighborhood thing. It's involved with a serious prison gang, and it's business, very serious business.
And that business is now crossing the line from street gang into organized crime. There is evidence that 18th Street is not only involved in heavy drug sales, but extortion, arms dealing, and wholesale murder. We'll have more on that tomorrow.
Chris, I'm curious, how is it that they've spread to so many different cities? Is it the drugs? Is that the draw?
Drugs is a draw, but also, you know, because they do draw heavily from illegal immigrant ranks. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're a very trenchant group, and family may move to Seattle. He's an 18th Streeter. He starts a branch there. Mm-hmm. He calls back his friends. They bring up more, and it just grows and grows and grows.
Well, okay.
Is there a hierarchy? Is there one or two people in charge?
I don't think you could really say that. I mean, there are ties to the Mexican Mafia, and a lot of people involved in this will say that the Mexican Mafia does some of the shot calling for 18th Streeters, because 18th Streeters have, say, a half dozen members that have come up through their ranks that are now pretty heavy hitters in the Mexican Mafia. Mm-hmm. So they reach back into these neighborhoods with their influence, and some will call them shot callers in 18th Street, but it's not clear exactly how that works.
Mm. Okay, we'll see you tomorrow with part two.
Thanks, Chris.
Is LA's largest gang, an estimated 12 to 20,000 members. They call themselves 18th Street.
Chris Blatchford joins us now in a part two of his series, 18th Street, reports the gang is evolving into a unit of organized crime. Chris.
Well, some gang investigators argue 18th Street is at best a loose-knit structure of criminals, but there are definite signs this former street gang has evolved into organized crime with a passion for easy money, drugs, extortion, and murder.
Got a confirmed buy. Give me a location, boy.
Drug sales are the lifeline for 18th Street gangsters. Here in Hollywood, 18th drug dealers swarm the streets 24 hours a day pushing crack cocaine. One patrol officer simply puts it this way.
They're everywhere.
Frustrated cops say they could bust 18th gangsters around the clock.
Okay, they're putting their hands up.
But just don't have the manpower. These two 18th Streeters are spotted on a Selma street corner selling rock cocaine.
Here we go, look at it.
Undercovers followed them to this nearby motel and found an 18th Street supply station, complete with dope and cash profits. An 18th Street cap marking the scene of the crime.
Roger, all three of these bodies involved? No, two.
Just moments later on a nearby street corner, another bust, another rock, and two more 18th Streeters busted. These two only 13 and 14 years old. This former gang member says 18th Street is like a chain store selling drugs.
It's like the corner store. When you open up a market, if you put it in a very good area, the business is good. And when their corner stores are located, they got very good business.
It is the same here in the Rampart area. A small army of 18th Street drug dealers overrun the neighborhood. INS agent Chris Carter works these streets too.
It's so rampant that they don't even stop when police cars go by. They just continue selling.
And in addition to selling drugs themselves, 18th Street collects a tax from other drug dealers for permission to operate in 18th Territory.
All these right here, they're all drug dealers. They all get taxed by 18th Street.
This former 18th Street collector, who does not want to be identified, took us on a tour.
People that pay you rent by the weekly, monthly, or daily. It could either be money or drugs or guns. They charge them by, you know, whenever they want to.
And there is a special treatment for those who refuse to pay.
Tell them, get the f*** out of here. Don't come back and sell around here. Kill them, mother.
20-year-old Jose Moro Argueta was a dealer who refused to pay his daily $40 tax. A painted cross now marks the spot where Moro was executed on a public sidewalk, shot down by an 18th Street enforcer.
A ruthless group of predators.
Deputy District Attorney George Castillo prosecuted the case.
Freddy Torres just cold-bloodedly blew his brains out there on the spot.
Trigger man Freddy prostitutes also pay up for permission to walk 18th Streets.
It terrifies me.
And this Rampart businessman, who also wants his identity hidden, says crooks aren't the only people stalked by 18th Street gangsters. for lease signs on local shops, he explains, speak for the dozens of merchants driven from the neighborhood by 18th Street extortion.
A gang member, three or four, walk in and they ask for monies, and they must give it up, or otherwise they promise them to burn their places.
He says street vendors are also forced to cough up money to 18th Street. Not even the ice cream man escapes payment. This federal document quotes an 18th Street enforcer saying he will kill anyone who turns him into the police. And this former gangster says murder is a common threat.
Definitely. They will be enforced. Disrespect will not be tolerated.
Police say Solo Sagato was an 18th Street strong-arm drug dealer and rent collector who disrespected his own gang. He and his girlfriend were shot down on a Rampart area street 4 months ago. She was 6 months pregnant. Detectives are still looking for the alleged hitman, 20-year-old 18th Street gangster Alfredo Silent Gomez. Homicide detective Jim Crawford.
Sagato apparently was overstepping his bounds, his power, and the green light was given by the Mexican Mafia.
Insiders say the Mexican Mafia, a ruthless prison gang, has close ties to 18th Street and gets a share of drug money collected by 18th Street gangsters. The DA's office reports it has handled 30 18th Street hits like this one during the last year alone. Many of the victims, drug dealers who refused to pay the tax. Prosecutor Castillo agrees 18th gangsters act like they own the public streets.
They're a cancer that needs rather major medical treatment, not simply an aspirin or a bandage. They're a group that need to be cut out through surgical methods out of the community before they spread and simply destroy the community.
Meanwhile, there are some dedicated citizen groups trying their best to cut 18th Street out of their neighborhood, but not nearly enough. And for those trying, it is a tough fight, and we'll have their story tomorrow.
Okay.
Thanks a lot, Chris. The biggest gang in L.A. This week we've shown you how the gangsters are spreading across the Southland, dealing drugs, death, and extortion.
Chris Blatchford joins us now with part three of his investigative series on 18th Street.
Well, as 18th Street gangsters take over our neighborhoods, some of their victims are fighting back. We warn you, a few of the pictures you are about to see are quite graphic.
Police find this man on a Hollywood sidewalk, a bloody mess. Witnesses say 18th Street gangsters beat him. An apparent random victim selected to feed 18th Street hunger for violence. Gang prosecutor George Castillo calls them predators.
When you join 18th Street, you've dedicated yourself to a small group of violent, crime-committing young men. It's nothing to be proud of. It's something that you should be disgraced by.
Check this out. Lifestyle of a nasty, notorious Southsider. Life.
But 18th Street gangsters revel in their violent lifestyle.
A lot of homeless on death row, doing life, a lot of years.
Here in Cudahy, a little gangster hand grabs a bottle.
Cudahy belongs to 18th Street.
And rockets it toward a passing car invading their neighborhood. Routine stops by police often seem amusing to the gangsters. And as they move in packs through Hollywood,
call PD, have them call PD.
Fights break out in the 18th Street wake. This Hollywood Division LAPD memo warns 18th Street continues to intimidate citizens who enter into their area. But longtime Hollywood resident David Carlin, who has recorded a small library of 18th Street drug dealers on videotape,
people are going to have to start standing up.
Says they don't scare him.
Are you going to leave because a bunch of punks that are illiterate come in and try to strong arm?
This 18th Street gangster, Ricardo Corda, allegedly did strong-arm Carlin. And Carlin is here in court to help prosecutors try to put Corda behind bars.
Is the person or persons that you encountered in this courtroom today?
One of them.
Point to that person, please, and describe what he or she is wearing.
That man over there in the blue.
Carlin's ready to testify. The 18th Street gangster struck him with this 2-foot metal bar as Carlin checked out some of the gang's graffiti in his neighborhood. But Deputy District Attorney Terry Bork, who is prosecuting the case, says unlike Carlin, 18th Street victims frequently are too scared to testify.
Because, in fact, they have been visited, they have received phone calls, or they have gotten a stare down from the defendant in court, or something like that, which does lead them to believe that there may be some retaliation or there may be some problem thereafter.
Here, a guardian angel patrol climbs up a building to get at 18th Streeters attacking them with bottles.
Hey, don't kill me.
But it was later the next night the angels finally caught up with the alleged attacker, an 18th Streeter called Green Eyes. The angels held him for the police, who took him away to face an assault charge.
We're arresting him for assault and deadly weapons, okay? Try some bottles.
In a series of Hollywood meetings,
it's you helping us and vice versa.
Special LAPD units have recently stirred up an effort to gain more community support for action against 18th Street.
A lot of people in the neighborhood are living in fear.
So here in the Wilshire area, another section infested with 18th Streeters.
Come on, invite you to a community meeting we're having tomorrow at 5.
Cops are also trying to get people to help take back the neighborhood, despite 18th efforts to even intimidate the cops.
If you see here, it says LAPD, and they put an X over the LAPD, so that means that they're signifying to us that they want to murder an LAPD officer.
Back in Hollywood, a hardcore community group dedicated to painting out 18th Street graffiti.
We've had guns pulled on us, things thrown at us, or paint knocked over. They come and threaten us every time we come out here.
Now often travels with a police officer ready to keep gangsters from retaliating.
Eventually, the community is going to put you all in jail. Do you understand that?
But here, a resident videotaping 18th Streeters on Hollywood Boulevard is accosted by an angry gangster.
What the f*** are you filming?
You?
What the f*** are you filming? That's what I'm telling you.
Who does not want his activities captured on home video.
Are you one of my filmers?
Yeah.
Meanwhile, community activist David Carlin says he would prefer to walk over 18th Street than have them walk over him. And he urges others to join the fight.
One thing they always like to do is say, we'll get you. And everybody is afraid of that. That's why so many people don't want to get involved with the courts, don't want to get involved with the police, because they feel that they're alienated once the thing has gone to court. But it's not necessarily true.
The man who allegedly assaulted Mr. Carlin will be back in court this Friday. He's being held in jail now on $65,000 bond. Meanwhile, 18th Street gangsters continue to flex their muscle elsewhere, and tomorrow, a look at how they seem to justify their lifestyle.
Good question. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Chris.
See you tomorrow. We have given you a look at 18th Street, the biggest gang in Los Angeles. If not to glorify them, some of you ask why.
With three decades of no publicity, 18th Street has grown from a half dozen to thousands of members. So maybe it's time to lift the veil of secrecy that has allowed it to spread. Fox Undercover's Chris Blatchford reports that many city neighborhoods live within the gang's grip. Chris.
And John, many of those neighborhoods now seem to accept 18th Street. After all, the gang is made up of several generations of their own children. To some, it has become family.
This is a gangland funeral. Another in a long line of 18th Street caskets headed for Los Angeles area graveyards. This one, like hundreds of others, carries the body of a teenager, 18-year-old Juan Thumper Bonilla, executed by rival gangsters who caught him in the wrong neighborhood.
I just want to say that I love him. He was a down homeboy.
Ironically, it is here at these funerals you see gangsters as people. They shed tears, show feelings, have grieving mothers and rows of friends.
He'll always be in my heart and always be there for all the homeboys. Because 18th Street is 18th Street, and they want to let everybody know he passed away for us.
It is this quality of loyalty, a sense of family, gangsters like to point to as something positive about their lifestyle. And there is no question, the sense of caring thousands of gang members get from 18th Street runs very deep.
I got a lot of pride for my name, but that's why I got on my eye. I don't give a f*** what anybody thinks.
But more and more think it is a false pride that scours the community with graffiti, scars our youth with gunshot wounds, and a twisted sense of right and wrong. 35-year-old gang veteran Alex Villapando calls the worst of it senseless.
They're 16, 17 years old. They don't even know what life was all about. Do they know what Disneyland was about? Do they know anything? No, all they know is about guns, crimes, and where you stand for, and that's kind of wrong.
Gangster, devil, but 18th Street breeds a blind loyalty, as seen with this 13-year-old recruit who has picked the nickname Gangster.
Live up to your name, homie.
And is immediately encouraged to become what his new name implies. Someday, he could be taking orders from Rene Boxer Ramirez, a Mexican mafia killer, who laughed as he sat in court facing two murder charges several years ago. Boxer, who has the black hand of the Mexican mafia tattooed on his chest, still, sources say, calls the shots in some West Side 18th Street neighborhoods from his prison cell. Gang prosecutor George Castillo says 18th Street merely exploits our youth.
Most of these young men, sooner or later, are going to wind up in one of two places. They're going to wind up in jail, or they're going to wind up dead.
Meanwhile, 18th Streeters march through the next series of funerals. There have been at least six 18th Streeters shot, two killed within the last few weeks. Gangsters like Buzzer seem programmed to accept the violence.
You never know when you're going to die. Somebody could come by right now and just shoot me. But if it happens, it happens.
$3!
It happened to homie Thumper and here his fellow 18th Streeters wash cars to pay for his funeral. Brothers 20-year-old Fingers here on the left, 18-year-old Sailor, and 11-year-old Little Puppet all help out. Their mother, like so many other gangster parents, can't seem to come to grips with the reality of 18th Street.
Basically, from what I've seen myself, they're all good kids. They just, once in a while, get in a little problem with the police.
That attitude of denial, say police.
How are you?
Good.
11.
Is one of the main reasons 18th Street has been able to grow unchecked to reach a membership total of 12 to 20,000.
And I'm telling you, it's just, you know, the sad part about it is that where before it didn't affect everybody, it could be your kid.
And by the time some of these kids see the dangers of joining up, claims Officer Camacho.
How long have you been in 18th Street?
8 years.
8 years?
There is no way out of the 18th Street life.
This is the life.
A life of drugs, dealing, death, and dismay. This former gangster, in and out of prison his entire life, says it is not worth it.
See, that's one thing a kid should be told, is that there's no future in it. I mean, where are you gonna go? You're gonna stay right here in this street corner for the rest of your life? There's more things out there, man.
But as long as gangs like 18th Street continue to grow, the future of small children like these, by the time they are teenagers, could be stuffed into a coffin, just like the homeboy they called Thumper.
Finally, our series has prompted a lot of letters from our viewers. A Cudahy resident who describes himself, quote, as a Latino who was embarrassed by the crude actions of a few, writes, "Let it be known to these gangsters that what they do is wrong and that our community will not put up with it much longer. They," he says, "are not cool. They," he adds, "put a dark cloud over the entire Latino community and how others look at Latinos in general."
He's announced the name of the next person to hit contestants' row.
Certainly, sir. We have Alex Villapando. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right, Alex.
Alex, it is a pleasure to have you join our happy little quartet. Now, may I direct your attention to the next item up for bids on The Price is Right.
Here is a new refrigerator freezer. GE side-by-side refrigerator freezer offers excellent storage capability, full-length freezer and fresh food compartments, includes a wide range of convenience features.
Alex, you get to bid on that before anyone else.
$1,350.
Okay, Philip?
$1,625.
$1,625, and the next bidder will be Evelyn.
$1,300.
Her bid is $1,300 even, and Cynthia, you get the last bid.
$1,300, $1,500.
$1,500. And the actual retail price of the refrigerator freezer is $1,600. The winner is Cynthia. Cynthia, would you join me over here at the giant price tag, please? Here we are, Cynthia. Now, thank you. Cynthia, all of us hope you end up with that.
A new car! The Plymouth Sundance Duster. This sporty two-door hatchback is economical and fun to drive. Comes equipped with standard features, air conditioning, power door locks, anti-lock brakes, cassette player, and California emissions.
Cynthia, my beauties are bringing out the dice with which you are going to win that car. Now, let me remind you that there are no numbers in the price of the car higher than six. Okay? No numbers higher than six. And there are no zeros in the price of the car. Now, the first number in the price of the car is one. I want you to roll that single die over this line and roll the second number in the price of the car. Roll it over this line. And she has rolled a two. Is that it? You got it. You got it. It is a $12,000 automobile. Now, the third number in the price of the car. Is it four? No. Now, do you believe that third number is higher or lower than four?
Higher, Bob.
Higher. Okay, take another and roll it over the line, and let's have the next number in the price of the car. Is it three? It is not. Is it higher or lower than three?
Higher.
Higher. And the last one. The last number, is it four? No. Is it higher or lower than four?
Higher.
Higher, she said. She believes all three are higher. All right. Show us the third number, please. Yes. Now, you went against the odds there, and you won. It could have been five or six, and you'd win, but it could have been one, two, or three, and you would have lost. Now, you went with the odds in the next number. Was she right? Yes, she was. Now again, she went against the odds. And did she win that car? Yes, she did. Cynthia has won the automobile, and Cynthia is plumb happy about the whole thing. Cynthia doesn't want to discuss it with me. She went over to pick up the pink slip. We'll play another pricing game with another contestant from our studio audience after we do a little business with you. All right, Rod, the eyes of the nation are upon you. As many as, what is it, 10 million viewers?
Oh, higher, higher, Bob.
Oh, really?
Higher, yes.
What is our...
The latest estimate is about 15 million people watching this show every day, Bob.
15 million.
That's right.
Now... how many of those folks are watching every day?
I would say that out of those, probably we have a steady viewing audience of people that never miss the show of about 10 million a day.
10 million?
Right.
So that means that 5 million different people see every day.
That's right.
So it's the same 10 million for 5 days, and then 5 million, well, it's a lot of people. It's a lot of people, right?
And that doesn't even include the ones that are showing in Europe now.
That's right.
That's right. We have the show in Europe, and we're everywhere, Bob. Everywhere
we
go.
We're on cable in Great Britain.
That's right.
And we're, of course, been in Canada for many, many years. And we're on cable in Mexico. And they're seeing the show in the Philippines, I believe, and
that's
in
right.
Guam, and in places in the Caribbean, and in Alabama. And, right, Philip? Who's our next player, Rod?
Well, all those 15 million people are about to see the lovely Marion Cano. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Hello, Miriam. Miriam is in contestant's row, so we're ready to see the next item up for bids.
A new bumper pool table. You and your family will have hours of enjoyment with this bumper pool table from Mikhail Darafee, featuring solid oak construction, accessories included.
And Miriam, will you please give us your bid on the bumper pool table?
$980.
$980. Alex, you're next.
$985.
$985? How about it, Philip?
$700.
$700. You get the last bid, Evelyn.
$825.
And the actual retail price of the bumper pool table is $1,525. The winner is Alex. Alex is the winner. Alex will play our pricing game, and he will play it right up here. Howdy, Alex. Alex, now that you're up here, you have an opportunity of winning this.
A new spa.
Presents the San Clemente Elite Spa. The octagonal design and deep footwell provide ample leg room and comfort for multiple users from Catalina Spas. A prize worth $5,345.
Alex, the game that you are about to play is called Super Saver, and the object of the game is to save at least $1. You are going to purchase four of these products. Now, these prices that you see are less than the price of the product. So what you want to do is to pick out ones that are as much less as possible so that you can win more money and get it into the bank. One of them is priced higher than the price of the product, but even if you made a mistake and got that one, it is still mathematically possible to win. Now, before he begins, Rod, I think it would be helpful to hear more about these products.
Then I shall say, Hershey Strawberry Drink Box is a perfect lunchbox item. Other flavors include genuine chocolate, chocolate marshmallow, and banana split. Lee Antifungal Instant Nail Glue for tips and repair. Lee in the Nail Beauty Products section, used as directed. Little Debbie Peanut Butter Bars by the box are single pack, individually wrapped, and so delicious. Little Debbie, America's number one snack cake. Static Guard does more than just eliminate static cling. Now, it's the easy way to brush pet hair away. New Woodrich from Pledge, the self-adjusting natural oil moisturizer that conditions wood where it needs it most. And Clorox Liquid Bleach removes tough stains even the best detergents can leave behind. Use Clorox Bleach to get your whites Clorox White.
Which one of those products are you going to buy first, Alex?
I'll go for the bleach.
The bleach is marked 40 cents. What is the price? 80 cents. And what has happened here? He has saved 40 cents. Put it in the bank, please. Very good. Now you have three to go. What's next?
The nail glue.
The nail glue marked $1.19. What is the price? $1.99. How much did he save? 80 cents. Put it in the bank. Now you have $1.20 in the bank. Just don't make any mistakes and you're a winner. Two to go.
Snack bars.
Snack bars. Mark, $1.09. And the price is? $1.29. He has saved 20 cents more. You have $1.40 in the bank and one last purchase.
Three. Drinks.
The drinks marked $1.49. What's the price? Oh, $1.09. How much did he lose? 40 cents. You still win because you have $1 in the bank. You did it. You did it, Alex. You're a winner. A winner. A spa for Alex, I say. And I say the second showcase showdown will follow this.
Appearing on stage will receive Village Wallpaper. Presents the complete look collection. This totally coordinated wallpaper, wall border, and comforter set make decorating as easy as 1, 2, 3. Village Wallpaper. And Dean's, the Dean of Dips, America's favorite brand. They're in the refrigerated case. Dean's, the Dean of Dips. Also, if you thought Tetris was fun, wait till you play Wordtris. Now the following pieces are letters. Wordtris for Game Boy and Super Nintendo. And now, here is Bob Barker with our Showcase Showdown.
Hi, thank you, Rod. And here are Cynthia, Alex, and Meredith, who won their way up on stage in this half of our show. Cynthia has won more than anyone else, a new automobile plus other prizes. She will spin the big wheel last. Alex, who is a super saver, if I ever saw one, is going to spin the big wheel second. And you, Meredith, are going to start things off, keeping in mind that the one of you three who is nearest to $1 without going over will be in the showcase. Step over there, Meredith. Grasp a handle or two and tug. There goes, folks. What will this spin be worth? This spin is worth, ooh, 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 95 cents. And Meredith does not want to spin anymore. She fled. Alex, your spin. Alex, he needs a dollar to take over the lead, 95 cents for a tie, and his spin is on its way. And his spin is coming to a stop on 40 cents. Spin it again, Alex. 60 cents would be a lovely sight. 40 cents in his first spin. Has to beat 95 cents to take over the lead. 40 cents and 80 cents ain't good. Thank you, Alex. And we are ready for Cynthia. Here is Cynthia's first spin. And Cynthia's first spin is coming to a stop on 50 cents. Now you get that one more time and we have $1,000 for you. 50 cents. She has to beat 95 cents to get into the showcase. 50 cents and a tie. All right. Right back over here, Cynthia. One spin, Meredith. It's a spin-off, ladies and gentlemen. One spin per customer. You still get $1,000 if you get a dollar. You still get your bonus spin. And in your spin-off spin, you have ended up with 70 cents. Back you go, and you will spin one time, Cynthia. One time, and she must beat 70 cents. One time. And I do believe that you have a nickel. Thank you, Cynthia. You're the winner, Meredith. You're in the showcase, Meredith. After this, Meredith.
All block, only from you stronger depend. Get back into life.
Contestants not appearing on stage will receive Village Wallpaper. It presents the complete look collection. This totally coordinated wallpaper, wall border, and comforter set make decorating as easy as 1, 2, 3. Village Wallpaper. And Dean's, the Dean of Dips, America's favorite brand. They're in the refrigerated case. Dean's, the Dean of Dips. Also, if you thought Tetris was fun, wait till you play Wordtris. Now the following pieces are letters. Wordtris for Game Boy and Super Nintendo. And now, here is Bob Barker with our showcase showdown.
Hi, thank you, Rod. And here are Cynthia, Alex, and Meredith, who won their way up on stage in this half of our show. Cynthia has won more than anyone else, a new automobile plus other prizes. She will spin the big wheel last. Alex, who is a super saver, if I ever saw one, is going to spin the big wheel second. And you, Meredith, are going to start things off, keeping in mind that the one of you three who is nearest to $1 without going over will be in the showcase. Step over there, Meredith. Grasp a handle or two and tug. There it goes, folks. What will this spin be worth? This spin is worth, ooh, 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 95 cents. And Meredith does not want to spin anymore. She fled. Alex, your spin. Alex, he needs a dollar to take over the lead, 95 cents for a tie, and his spin is on its way. And his spin is coming to a stop on 40 cents. Spin it again, Alex. 60 cents would be a lovely sight. 40 cents in his first spin. Has to beat 95 cents to take over the lead. 40 cents and 80 cents ain't good. Thank you, Alex. And we are ready for Cynthia. Here is Cynthia's first spin. And Cynthia's first spin is coming to a stop on 50 cents. Now you get that one more time and we have $1,000 for you. 50 cents. She has to beat 95 cents to get into the showcase. 50 cents and a tie. All right, right back over here, Cynthia. One spin, Meredith. It's a spin-off, ladies and gentlemen. One spin per customer. You still get $1,000 if you get a dollar. You still get your bonus spin. And in your spin-off spin, you have ended up with 70 cents. Back you go, and you will spin one time, Cynthia. One time, and she must beat 70 cents. One time, and I do believe that you have a nickel. Thank you, Cynthia. You're the winner, Meredith. You're in the showcase, Meredith. After this, Meredith.
Are there some days your hair needs more conditioning? Some days it needs less?
No matter what your hair goes through, Vanessa is always there for you. Vanessa, your hair's too beautiful.
Vanessa Adjusting Conditioner tracks your hair's changing needs. Conditions more on days you need it, less on days you don't.
Vanessa, your hair too beautiful.
This graph shows a painful leg cramp, but nighttime leg cramps can be prevented with Juvel, a muscle relaxant plus vitamin E. Take Juvel before bedtime for a good night's sleep, because Juvel helps stop leg cramps before they start.
Hey, at home or on the go, nothing's easier than Static Guard for stopping static cling, anytime, anywhere.
Thanks for the tip.
Static Guard, the easy way to spray cling away.
The Big Apple, fastest city on earth. We're here to introduce something new, oatmeal crisp with apples. With so much to savor, no one can rush through a bowl. Crispy pieces of real apple and a touch of cinnamon. Plus, big flakes bursting with hearty oatmeal baked to a brown sugar crunch. A Big Apple tastes so new, everyone's taking their sweet time. New oatmeal crisp with apples, the taste that refuses to be rushed.
Are we okay?
Oh, not really, no. I'm all stuffed up.
I'm all stuffed up.
Well, I got a sore throat and a cough.
Well, me too.
Well, stop complaining.
I'm not complaining.
Somebody is complaining.
Then we'll take something.
Not that cough syrup makes me gag.
When you're all blocked up, Ludens helps. Fast-acting cough suppressants with menthol vapor relief.
I can breathe.
For serious vapor relief, Ludens helps. Really help.
An angry father.
She's going to mess up her life forever. I'm not going to stand by as a father and watch that happen.
A concerned mother.
What if she never forgets us?
A rebellious daughter.
I am really sick and tired of everyone telling me that this is not going to last.
All collide.
I want my daughter out of this relationship by the end of this week.
This week on The Young and the Restless.
In this small western town, she's going to do what no one has ever seen.
If this doesn't work, everyone will blame me.
Jane Seymour, Dr. Quinn, Saturday.
Janine is the top winner in our showcase today. Meredith is the runner-up, and they want to see the first showcase, please.
This showcase contains prizes designed for the kids, and we will start with a selection of animated videos, a color television, and a VCR. From MGM UA Home Video, this collection of 30 animated video cassettes features Bugs Bunny, Porky Pig, Daffy Duck, and includes beloved classics by Dr. Seuss. And RCA's home theater 35-inch console TV with advanced color picture-in-picture that allows you to watch two shows at once. Broadcast area reception and surround sound from RCA and Samsung's high-tech remote control VCR with advanced features including on-screen programming, four video heads, and one-year eight event programmability from Samsung Electronics. Next for the little kids, a selection of brand new toys. Little Tykes, a collection of toys that provides hours of creative play. Little Tykes, plastic toys with a reputation for durability and quality. And for the big kids, a trip to fabulous Disneyland in Europe. You and three companions will fly round trip coach from Los Angeles to Paris for a six-night stay in luxury accommodations at the New York Hotel, an official Euro Disneyland hotel. You'll also receive four three-day passes to Euro Disneyland just outside of Paris, where a spectacular new world of Disney imagination and adventure awaits you from the magic world of Euro Disney theme park. And this showcase containing prizes designed for the kids can be yours if the price is right.
Janine, are you going to bid or pass?
On Disney? Euro Disney?
Yeah, Euro Disney.
I'll pass.
You will pass to Meredith. What's your bid, Meredith?
I'll say
$8,590. $8,590 for her, and now, Janine, this showcase is for you.
Janine, your showcase begins with stylish furniture for your office. Stanley Furniture's Meridian Collection of contemporary furnishings designed for home or office. Exceptional styling and masterful craftsmanship, the office from Stanley Furniture. And after a hard day working in your office, find time to relax in your delightful new living room. Dick Reed named this living room group Recollections. It is reminiscent of the 1940s rattan-style furniture. This updated version features an umberwood finish and colorful floral fabric. And under all this furniture, there's 40 square yards of carpeting from Omega Carpet and Rug Mills. This luxurious carpeting features stain release and is designed for years of enjoyment. Beautifully colored carpeting from Omega. And for recreational fun, spend the day exploring the outdoors in your terrific new amphibious car. A six-wheel drive all-terrain amphibious car propelled by four cycle engine moves through fields, mud, snow, lakes, and rivers. This showcase can be yours if the price is right.
What do you bid on this showcase, Janine? $10,500 is her bid, and we'll be right back.
Beautiful morning, huh?
Morning ain't my time, Bert.
Howdy, a glass of energy for my friend. What you need is some port orange juice with vitamin C and natural energy to get you moving.
I'm feeling that get up and go already.
100% pure Florida orange juice. It'll get you on your feet.
Everyone's looking for a good value these days. I'm no different. I buy bargain brands for some things. But when it's medicine I put in my body, especially a pain reliever, then I choose Advil. My doctor recommended it by name, and I've had it work on enough headaches to know it really does the job. The price? Advil can be only pennies per tablet, and if that's all it costs to help get rid of my pain, I call that real value. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
The power of gold is the power to clean. Eureka Powerline. New 8.5 big amps. Attachments on board to clean anywhere. Traps the dirt. Keeps it here. New Powerline by Eureka.
Guess what's made for your Ultra Downy bottle? The Ultra Downy Refill. You don't even add water to the bottle. And the tiny cap makes all this fluffy softness. Forget big bottles and big caps. The Ultra Downy Refill and your little Ultra Downy bottle. They're made for each other.
Now you can make Betty Crocker's sweet and sour chicken by the book or by the jar. Introducing Betty Crocker recipe sauces. Just pour, simmer, and enjoy Betty's best recipes in every jar.
Meredith bid $8,590 on her showcase, and the actual retail price is $12,066, a difference of $3,576. Janine bid $10,500 on her showcase, and the actual retail price of her showcase is $16,115, a difference of $5,615. You win, Meredith. Meredith is our winner. Thank you, Janine. Congratulations. Bob Barker reminding you to help control the pet population. Have your pets spayed or neutered. Goodbye, everybody.
Behind the ceremonies and celebration, Eye on America, tonight on the CBS Evening News.
Tonight, the hottest superstars come together for the entertainment event of the year. An American reunion, the 52nd Presidential Inaugural Gala, tonight.
The big day is here. Are you ready? He is the man soon to become the 42nd President of the United States, and the world is watching.
Remedy, food of the gods, special being with